What is your full name?
My full name is Gagan Malhotra.
Where are you from?
I am from Patiala.
Do you work or are you a student?
Currently, I am working as a content developer in an education institute in Patiala.
Can I see your ID?
Yes, please.
Tell me about your workplace.
I've started as working as a content developer in an education institute, as I've told you. My work requires me to read every day and collect, compile and write about things that pertain to the subjects that I'm writing about.
Do you live in a house or flat?
I live in a house. We have recently refurbished our entire house. We have equipped it with all the modern facilities.
What would you prefer for the future, a house or an apartment, and why?
I've never really thought about it, but it would depend totally upon where I live. As I intend to go to Canada, if I end up getting a city job, preferably I'll get an apartment for myself. But in case I don't get the job that I want, so I would like to prefer to live in Kamloops, which is a hill station in British Columbia. So there I would preferably have a house to myself.
Okay, let's talk about comedy. Do you like comedy?
Yes, of course. I do like comedy as a genre. But in India, the kind of comedy which is done often touches upon sensitive subjects where women or color is mocked about. So I don't like that black side of the comedy, but whenever there is humorous pun involved and it is light-hearted, I do like comedy.
Okay. Would you like to watch a live comedy show?
Yes, indeed. I have watched several comedy shows. Once, a few months ago, in December, I think, a popular stand-up comedian, Zakir Khan, came to a university which is located in Patiala. So I went to see that show.
Do you tell jokes to your friends?
Honestly, I don't think that I'm a funny person, but I think I'm awkward, so they usually laugh and have fun about my awkwardness, but I don't have any jokes to tell.
Okay. What is the meaning of person's national identity?
A person's national identity describes that where a person hails from. And whenever they are outside of their country, their national identity defines them as an individual. So if they commit any wrong in some foreign territory, so they are expected to be repatriated to their native country.
How it is different from a person's global identity?
Now, in this era of globalization, national boundaries are obliterated, because usually, whenever we think about studying or even working, we think in global terms, not in national terms. So a global identity would mean where a person is currently, not where he hails from, rather where he is now.
Okay, let's talk about art. Did you like art in school?
I think I was a very poor student when I was in school. I lacked concentration and didn't really focus on anything, so I don't think so I was good at art.
Have you been to an art gallery before?
Yes, indeed, I have been to several art galleries when I was studying in Delhi. So there are several museums and art galleries located in central Delhi. Whenever there was an exhibition by any renowned artist, I used to go and visit.
All right, now I will give you a 2-minute topic. You will have 1 minute to prepare on that topic and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. Fine? Here is your cue card. This is your paper and pencil.
Can I start?
Yes.
We are living in an era which is really technologically advanced, and nowadays we do depend on a lot of applications to navigate our life. For example, if we have to go someplace, usually use Google Maps or GPS. But as I am expected to talk about an application that I use daily, I would like to talk about the application which is Evernote. This is an application where I can write and edit whatever I read or compile as a content developer. My job requires me to compile a lot of information, so which requires a lot of editing. This platform enables me to not only compile but edit it often. Moreover, this is free and I really enjoy this the interface of this platform, which is really user friendly. I came across this platform when I was watching television. It was being advertised in one of the channels that I was watching, and when it prompted me to further inquire about this platform, and when I realized that this platform is free of cost, I decided to use it. I enjoy using it most because not only it is free, it is really productive and efficient. It has enabled me to do my work really efficiently and has often enabled me to garner a lot of praise from my boss. So this was a program that I use often in my daily life.
Okay, can I have paper pencil back?
Yes, please.
Okay, now I will ask you a few questions related to this topic. What other programs do people use in your country?
India is a very diverse country. It would be imprudent of me to generalize what are the most popular programs, but if I am to generalize, I would say most of the people do use social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, and the other people who are really opinionated nowadays tend to use Twitter and LinkedIn.
Why do you think some people choose not to use any apps?
I think there, I do know a few people who do not want to use any apps because they think that technology is effectively interfering in their lifestyles. The phenomena whereby anyone can have access to your personal life, your space, that these social media platforms are essentially doing. They want to keep their lives private and don't want to give that accessibility to everyone around them. That is why they eschew and abstain from using those platforms.
Do young people and old people use the same applications or programs?
Well, yes and no. Some people can. I think some applications can be used by both young people as well as elderly ones, but there is visible difference. For example, my mother usually uses YouTube to listen to bhajans and songs, while I, on the other hand, use a lot of platforms that enable me to read newspaper and editorials. So there is a difference.
Do you think the constant development of technology can affect people, and in what way?
Yes. Interestingly, I read an article whereby the word of the year 2020 was named to be technoference, which essentially means that technology is interfering in our lifestyle. So yes, I do think that constant development, although is important, but is having repercussions on individuals' life. Like, we are becoming isolated and alienated from real relationships, and we are more focused on virtual relationships. Our face-to-face interactions have been kind of completely replaced by Facebook interactions or interactions that take place on social media. And moreover, there is a culture where people have become mute spectators. I often see that people take out their camera whenever there is something wrong rather than doing something about it. So yes, technology is a double-edged sword whereby it has some merits, but it does have its fair share of demerits.
All right, this is the end of your speaking. Thank you.